Hello there, good morning. You're watching Proactive London and Matthew Stork is joining us today from Cambridge Cognition Holdings. A very good day to you. How are you today?
Good morning, very well, thank you.
Good morning. Well, pleasure to have you with us today because we're going to learn more about what you do as a company. We'll also talk about your results that were published today as well, plus just a few of your projections and goals and ambitions for the company too, and of course how the pandemic has impacted your operations. So first of all, for the benefit of those people who aren't yet familiar with what you do there, what is your company exactly?
Well, Cambridge Cognitions is a digital health technology company, and we provide objective measurements of brain health, and our team are real experts in developing and commercializing digital clinical assessments, most used in clinical trials, sometimes in healthcare. And we also do questionnaires and scales. It's a smaller part of our business, but growing, which also collects more clinical information about patients, again, mostly for clinical trials. So that's kind of the essence of what we provide, the kind of two product areas. And we're a leading company in the sector with good global reach and in a very nice growth position, as you might have seen from our results.
Yeah, well, let's move on to that now, because I was scanning at the details of them this morning. So you've described them as strong and profitable for the first half, delivering revenues of £4.5 million. That's a 50% year-on-year growth. What's driving that exactly? What's driving this performance, would you say?
Well, a number of things. I mean, firstly, we've really focused on commercial execution. So improving our coverage and reach of our sales teams and sales and marketing teams, and stepping up the conversion rate over time gradually. Also, a couple of years ago, we've developed broadened our offering. We've really started selling those much more actively in the last couple of years, and we're seeing the benefit of that now as that's come through. And then finally, there is underlying market growth. So there's been more interest in central nervous systems drug development. So there's been a 20% upswing in number of central nervous systems clinical trials, and more drugs in the preclinical stage of drug development. So we also expect that to continue, that increase over time. And we really specialize in central nervous systems kind of drug development, or particularly clinical trials for those.
Mm-hmm. I will get onto those in a bit, but you said broadening your offering. What do you mean by that exactly?
So for a number of years, we've marketed a cognitive assessment called CANTAB. Really well known. There's around 2,500 clinical trials using CANTAB, and that is an assessment that has worked really well in clinics. And we've broadened that out by adding very short digital cognitive tests. So they take 30 seconds or so. They run on mobile phones. Really suit clinical trials that are hybrid or virtual, operating out of people's homes. And we've also developed what's called an electronic clinical outcomes assessment, questionnaires and scales as well. So we've been upselling from CANTAB to shorter tests as well, to ECOA, questionnaires and scales. And in the last half, we've also put into production, available for clinical trials, though we're doing validation studies now, of verbal cognitive assessments. So in the past, we've been doing screen-based assessments. Now we're doing voice-based assessments as well. We're starting. That's very exciting. A lot of potential in that area as well.
Gosh, it's fascinating. And explain to us maybe how the pandemic has actually accelerated this interest in virtual clinical trials.
Well, there's been growing interest in it gradually over time for kind of 10 years or so. And that's because you can get, you know, real world data as well as clinic-based data. So you can get data for a clinical trial that, instead of being kind of two time points of data, you can also collect variations in a disease state over time. And there's been some arguments say that it also could be a lower cost way of conducting clinical trials. And you can capture more patients because some people simply can't make it to a clinical trial site. Or if they you know, haven't got mobility, then travel's difficult, for example, they don't want to get involved in clinical trials. So there's a number of reasons why virtual clinical trials have been growing over time quite gradually. However, since COVID-19 occurred, a number of hospitals obviously shut their doors to anything other than COVID patients or emergencies, and many clinical trial centers did the same thing. So there was almost a shock to the clinical trial industry middle of last year when a number of trials kind of halted and there were delays And the pharmaceutical industry, their lifeblood is drug development and clinical trials. They can't launch products without them. So they're really looking at ways to virtualize clinical trials and not moving them necessarily wholly to being at home, but, you know, a middle point is one or two clinic visits instead of, say, 10. Mm-hmm. The rest of the clinical trial measurements can be at home. And we've got an ideal portfolio for central nervous systems, for cognitive or brain health measurements at home, as well as in clinical trial centres. So it's been good for us.
Yeah, quite right. Really interesting chatting to you. Thank you very much indeed for introducing your company to us here at Proactive. That's Matthew there from Cambridge Cognition Holdings here on Proactive London today.
Thank you. Been a pleasure.